already unable to attend, unable to touch forward, once those who are able have done so, then please drive up to the covered walkway, and the minister will bring the meeting to you while you're meeting here. Again, then simply return to your spot in the parking lot for the remainder of this celebration. Thank you, and we will begin shortly. Once again, good morning, everyone, and welcome. Please stand, let's sing together, "I Heard the Voice of Jesus Say," and it's number 462. This is the time of fulfillment. The reign of God is at hand. This is the time of fulfillment. The reign of God is at hand. Come drink the living water of life, the water of life. This is the time of fulfillment. The reign of God is at hand. The reign of God is at
together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
The good news is a lot of people set their clocks right. For the times we have sinned, for the times we have failed, we call these to mind, and so prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned, in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
So Moses cried out to the Lord, "What shall I do with this people?
little more and they will stone me." The Lord answered Moses, "Go over there in front of the people, along with some of the elders of Israel, holding in your hand as you go the staff with which you struck the river. I will be standing there in front of you on the rock in Horeb. Strike the rock, and the water will flow from it for the people to drink." This Moses did in the presence of the elders of Israel. The place was called Massa and Meribah, because the Israelites quarreled there and tested the Lord, saying, "Is the Lord in our midst or not?" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus Christ, King of heaven.
according to John. Jesus came to a town of Samaria called Sychar, near the plot of land that Jacob had given to his son Joseph. Jacob's well was there. Jesus, tired from the journey, sat down there at the well. It was about noon. A woman of Samaria came to draw water. Jesus said to her, "Give me a drink." His disciples had gone into the town to buy food. The Samaritan woman said to him, "How can you, a Jew, ask me, a Samaritan woman, for a drink?" For Jews used nothing in common with Samaritans. Jesus answered and said to her, "If you knew the gift of God, and who is saying to you, 'Give me a drink,' you would have asked him, and he would have given you living water." The woman said to him, "Sir, you do not even have a bucket, and the cistern is deep. Where then can you get this living water? Are you greater than our father Jacob, who gave us this cistern and drank from it himself with his children and his flocks?" Jesus answered and said to her, "Everyone who drinks this water will be thirsty again. But whoever drinks the water I give will never thirst. The water I shall give will become in him a spring of water welling up to eternal life." The woman said to him, "Sir, give me this water, so that I may not be thirsty or have to keep coming here to draw water." Jesus said to her, "Go, call your husband and come back." The woman answered and said to him, "I do not have a husband." Jesus answered her, "You are right in saying, 'I do not have a husband,' for you have had five husbands, and the one you have now is not your husband. What you have said is true." The woman said to him, "Sir, I can see that you are a prophet. Our ancestors worshipped on this mountain, but you people say that the place to worship is in Jerusalem." Jesus said to her, "Believe me, woman, the hour is coming when you will worship the Father, neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem. You people worship what you do not understand. We worship what we understand, because salvation is from the Jews. But the hour is coming, and is now here, when true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. And indeed, the Father seeks such people to worship him. God is spirit, and those who worship him must worship in spirit and truth." The woman said to him, "I know that the Messiah is coming, the one called the Christ. When he comes, he will tell us everything." Jesus said to her, "I am he, the one speaking with you." At that moment, his disciples returned and were amazed he was talking with a woman. But still no one said, "What are you looking for?" or "Why are you talking with her?" The woman left her jar and went into the town and said to the people, "Come, see a man who told me everything I have done. Could he possibly be the Christ?" They went out of the town and came to him. Meanwhile, the disciples urged him, "Rabbi, eat." But he said to them, "I have food to eat, of which you do not know." So the disciples said to one another, "Could someone have brought him something to eat?" Jesus said to them, "My food is to do the will of the one who sent me and to finish his work. Do you not say, 'In 4 months the harvest will be here'? I tell you, look up. See the fields ripe for the harvest. The reaper is already receiving payment and gathering crops for eternal life, so that the sower and reaper can rejoice together. For here the saying is verified that one sows and another reaps. I sent you to reap what you have not worked for. Others have done the work, and you are sharing the fruits of their work. Many of the Samaritans of that town began to believe in him because of the word of the woman who testified, "He told me everything I have done." When the Samaritans came to him, they invited him to stay with them, and he stayed there 2 days. Many more began to believe in him because of his word, and they said to the woman, "We no longer believe because of your word, for we have heard for ourselves. And we know that this is truly the Savior of the world." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
With all of the reports that surround cyber and internet security these days, reports of large companies, even agencies or our own government, experiencing social media accounts, servers, emails, personal bank or credit accounts being hacked or compromised, more and more we see a requirement to tighten up that security. More and more, we see the requirement for additional steps of authentication. And as tedious and perhaps even as frustrating as this can be for so many of us, it's a necessary reality in these modern times. In some ways, it's this level of additional security that sets in motion, in this weekend's gospel, this most unlikely and unusual encounter between Jesus and the Samaritan woman. Now, while it's true that in the ancient Mediterranean world, women had their time at the well and the marketplace, and men had their time at the well and the marketplace, and these two times never coincided. And she chose a time when even the women in the area would not have been at the well. An unusual time, noon, the highest point of the sun, the brightest part of the day, the hottest part of the day. She chose that time, which would ensure her that no one else would be there. She needed that assurance since she really was trying to avoid anyone ridiculing her for her checkered and tainted history. And she would succeed then in not running into anyone else, not risking that. She would succeed in not being shunned or ridiculed because of her history. Now, one can only imagine what must have gone through her mind when here she approaches this well and she sees a man sitting at the very well that she's going to draw water from. And at least from what we hear in this gospel story, she recognized it wasn't just simply any man. He was a Jewish man. He was an enemy of her people, which certainly would make her an enemy of hers. And here she finds herself, alone, unchaperoned, a strange man speaking to her in public, a man who did not hesitate to engage her in conversation, all of which was unheard of in that day and age. And truthfully, it's still unheard of in parts of Middle Eastern cultures even today. Jesus knew what was at stake for him and for her, as did she. But what was at stake for her went beyond the societal restrictions of the day. This woman went to the well for one thing, and one thing only: water. Water to fill her jug. And instead of filling her jug with the water she was convinced she needed, instead of filling it with the water she had traveled such a distance to obtain and so carefully at a particular time, Jesus gave her something more. He provided her with that additional piece of authentication, revealing to her her true self, her authentic self. And while she never filled her jug, she herself was filled with something more. Something much greater. Something that could not be contained in some clay jug, but rather found its way to her very soul, her spirit. She was filled with faith in the very stranger who sought her out. Filled with this more, having now been authenticated, having now had revealed to her her true self, this woman becomes a messenger to others about Jesus. A messenger whose message leads to not only others coming to believe in him, but others literally seeking him out. My friends, Jesus wants nothing more than to authenticate us. He sits at the well. He waits for us, inviting us not to worry about bringing our jugs, but wanting to fill us with our true selves. Give us the more that he offers, the more that authenticates us. Despite any weaknesses or limitations we feel we may have, the more that will become in us, each and every one of us, that spring of water welling up to eternal life. In Christ, our hope and our life, our God has proven God's love for us. May we then pray this day and always with confidence and in trust.
That in the wilderness of this world, the church may be the rock of God, providing waters of life to all who thirst, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That on the upcoming occasion of the 10th anniversary of the election of Pope Francis as head of the Church, he may continue to be strengthened and guided by the Holy Spirit as he faithfully shepherds the flock of believers entrusted to his care. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who control worldly power and shape human wisdom may attend to the law of God and respond to the needs of the lowly, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and suffering, especially Fred Burkhart, John Chartarino, Bob Christian, Danny Firth, Floss Firth, Mike Firth, Dacia Firthney, Patricia Hartley, Joyce Moore, Agnes Moran, Dora Quattrocchi, Brooke Russell, Carol Scally, Katrina Shunk, Paula Simmons, Clara Whitus, John Wright, as well as the victims and survivors of clergy sexual abuse in our church, may find strength and patience in Christ proclaimed. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Messiah may bestow on the elect of our church the living water that will become a spring leaping up to eternal life, and grant candidates for full reception into the church, along with our candidates for confirmation and the reception of First Communion, the grace to be faithful to the path they are on. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who hunger for meaning may draw closer to Christ and place Him at the center of their lives, and any missing from our assembly or other church communities may be led through the desert to a renewal of their lives, welcomed by us and others. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have recently died, Reverend Ralph Coletta, Reverend John Crawford, as well as Chuck Weiss, for whom this Mass is offered, and all of the dead who in life were fashioned as living stones into the temple of Christ's body, may be raised up from death to eternal joy with Christ. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may be confident God will provide for the needs that remain deep in the silence of our minds and hearts, along with those written in our prayer notebook and those we have been asked to pray for through our Renewal Recommitment Initiative. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O God, the living fountain of new life, to the human race, parched with thirst, you offer the living water of grace that springs up from the rock, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Grant your people the gift of the Spirit, that we may learn to profess our faith with courage and conviction, and announce with joy the wonders of your saving love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Our offertory chant will sing Come to the Water, and it's number 619.
Oh,
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Be pleased, O Lord, with these sacrificial offerings, and grant that we who beseech pardon for our own sins may take care to forgive our need. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. In a similar way on that same evening, he took the chalice of blessing in his hands, confessing your mercy, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Takes away everything that estranges us from one another. May he make your church a sign of unity and an instrument of your peace among all people. And may he keep us in communion with Francis our Pope and Edward our Bishop and all the bishops and your entire people. Just as you have gathered us now at the table of your Son, so also bring us together with the glorious Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and all the saints, with our brothers and sisters and those of every race and tongue who have died in your friendship. Bring us to share with them the unending banquet of unity in a new heaven and a new earth, where the fullness of your peace will shine forth in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
For anyone who drinks it says the Lord, the water I will give will become in them a spring welling up to eternal life. Chant, let's sing together as the leader, and it's number 136.
You are.
So I have
the body of Christ
for you.
The body of Christ.
So I have all for you.
The body of receive the pledge of things yet hidden in heaven, and are nourished while still on earth with the bread that comes from on high, we humbly entreat you, O Lord, that what is being brought about in us in mystery may come to true completion. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I'd ask you just to be seated for a moment. Brian Perkins, our Life Team Coordinator, has a few words to share.
Was weekends at a college, away from my parents, solo. And it ended up being one of the best experiences of my life. Just being there on campus, looking around, seeing these thousands of high schoolers my own age, being on fire for the faith, reverently praying in mass, actually paying attention. And then all the speakers, everything that they were saying, the things that were on my mind, the things I was struggling with, they were all addressing. It's like they were talking directly to me. This all culminated Saturday night with Eucharistic Adoration, where I feel like I really encountered the Lord for the first time, and suddenly everything just makes sense. Why we come to church, why we do the things that we do, everything just clicked, and it changed my life forever. I went from the kid who my parents had to drive to church to the kid who asked to borrow a car so I could go to youth group. And I've been back to every single conference that I could until I graduated. I went to Franciscan University for college. I've been back once for a youth conference, and now this summer we're going again. We're partnering with Holy Family Church in Stowe. I'd like to invite all the eligible youth from Our Lady of Victory to come with me. So it's open to all current eighth graders up to current high school seniors. Registration is due April 1st, and I hope to see everyone there. Thank you for your time, and God bless.
Just so you're aware, I know that an email went out, it's been posted, I believe, on Facebook. I think it's also on our parish website. There is information on how to register and get registered. Again, that's for current eighth graders through senior high. So, you know, perhaps you don't have a child, but your children have children who are of that age. You know, so aunts, uncles, and grandparents, you know, certainly be an influence, you know, invite them. There is a cost. There's a deposit that's due, and then there's a cost for the event. But for those who are struggling with paying on that, they need to speak to me, and we may be able to make arrangements to help supplement the cost of that. So again, I would urge you, reach out to others and or you yourself. Certainly give it some consideration. I wish to continue to thank those giving of their time, their talent, and their treasure that supports your parish's mission and ministry. Don't forget your bulletins, take fives, or the entrance to the church as well. Envelope users, do remember to use the collection boxes. We continue to collect alms throughout this season of Lent. Again, those will be divided evenly once the season is over between Blessed Trinity Food Pantry and Talmadge Good Neighbors. You can always use Faith Direct to make a contribution. Some particular inserts to point out. There's one in this weekend's bulletin with regard to 40 hours of prayer in support of life and the ways that you can support that, which takes place next Saturday. A rosary will be prayed in church at 4:30 p.m. I believe on the back side of that, there's important information about upcoming legislation that will impact the protection of human life and your call to action to address that. Following the celebration, it's Faith, Family, and Fun. For our families, in particular, parish school religion families, but all families. And that begins in Infinity Hall at 9:45 a.m. We hope to see at least some of you back this afternoon at 2 p.m. in room 101 of the parish center. Our own Miguel Chavez and his twin brother, PJ, will be presenting to us a Lenten afternoon of reflection, Living Water, Anchored in Love. It's focused on this particular gospel that we've heard. word today. So again, please join us for them. This Wednesday is Stations of the Cross at 7 p.m. Next Sunday, for any who are sinners, and there's probably at least two of us here, there's a communal reconciliation service at 2 p.m. at St. Joseph in Cuyahoga Falls at a Lenten area parish celebration. There will be several confessors available, so again, we hope to see you there for them. Also, next Sunday, just a reminder to our middle school, our high school, and our college youth, that will be our first rehearsal for this year's Mind Stations of the Cross. That will take place at 4:30 p.m., so we certainly hope to see you there. And for those who love to clean, we'd love to have you clean. And do, again, a reminder, mark your calendars for Friday, March 24th. That's the first date we're going to try. In case something interferes with that, I'm not sure what that is, then that will be moved to March 31st. So bring your buckets, your Murphys, your rags, whatever you need to clean, and we'll put you to work. The Lord be with you. Direct, O Lord, we pray, the hearts of your faithful, and in your kindness grant your servants this grace, that abiding in the love of you and their neighbor, they may fulfill the whole of your commandments. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. And our recessional Lent sing again, we keep this solemn fast. It's number one.